Planet Earth has provided a home to over 100 billion humans since the dawn of time. Along with countless other species with whom we share our world, Mother Nature provides the resources we use to shelter ourselves, to feed ourselves, and to enjoy the little bit of time we have on this planet. The tool we use to understand our planet, our home, the rocks it's made of, and the processes that allow it and us to exist is geology. And the tool we're going to use to explore geology is a pencil. What does a pencil have to do with geology? Well, let's take a look at the different parts of a pencil. The pencil lead is arguably the most important part, but as you may know, the lead isn't actually lead. It's a mixture of clay and graphite, each of which has to be pulled out of the earth before being ground up and combined into a paste and then squeezed through a tiny tube. If you've ever tried to do your math homework in pen, you truly understand the value of an eraser. Most erasers are made of synthetic rubber, which comes from petroleum byproducts. That petroleum comes from drilling oil from the ground, which requires a great deal of geologic understanding to accomplish. The rubber is combined with pumice and other mineral fillers like pigments, all of which also come out of the ground. Holding the eraser onto the pencil is a small metal sleeve called a ferrule that is usually made of aluminum, which, of course, comes out of the ground. But the shaft of the pencil is made of wood. No geology there, right? Except for the part where you have to chop down the tree, cut it up, ship it, cut it down some more, stick some lead into it and glue it together, all of which requires who knows how many tools and machines made of metal, which comes out of the ground, and which consume fuel, which often comes out of the ground. And we can't forget the pencil's layer of paint, which includes mineral-based pigments that also need to come out of the ground. Every part of this pencil is made from or made with something that came from the earth. There's an old saying amongst geologists that goes, "If it can't be grown, it must be mined." If you take a look at literally everything around you, it either came from the earth or was made with something that did. You cannot escape geology. The average American makes use of 17,200 kilograms of mined resources every year, not including energy resources like gas and coal. One person, 17,200 kilograms. That includes stone, sand, limestone, iron, aluminum, and all the other stuff we use to construct buildings, roads, cars, tires, cell phones, shoes, Game Boys, bobby pins, guitar strings, glasses, and the thousands upon thousands of other things that make up our daily lives. So if you started this video thinking that geology was just about rocks, I hope you can see now that it's both more involved and important than that. Right, Wayne? Right. Geology is the study of the Earth, how it does things, why it does things, and what it's made of. Geology works with biology to understand fossils and the ancient ecosystems they come from. Geology works with chemistry and physics to understand the compositions, formations, and interactions between minerals, not to mention the upheaval of mountains and the shifting of tectonic plates. Geology works with computer science to help us analyze measurements of our planet, and to make predictions about the future of our home. We're going to explore all of this and more on our journey into the geosciences as we visit national parks, hot springs, canyons, waterfalls, glaciers, and look at fossils, gemstones, and anything else we find along the way.